تهديه ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله أدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الغمة وتركنا على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن استنى بسنته إلى يوم الدين وبعد إخوتي الكرام أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله عز وجل كما قال سبحانه يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله ولتنظر نفس ما قدمت لغد واتقوا الله إن الله خبير بما تعملون ولا تكونوا كالذين نسوا الله فأنساهم أنفسهم أولئك هم الفاسقون لا يستوي أصحاب النار وأصحاب الجنة أصحاب الجنة هم الفائزون اللهم ارزقنا الإخلاص في القول والعمل آمين يا رب العالمين. Respected brothers and sisters in Islam, when a person accepts the Islam, we call him a Muslim, the one who submits himself to the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The one who says that now I have set boundaries, I have to see what pleases Allah and what are the teachings of Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And that's what the word Muslim means, the one who submits to the commands of Allah azza wa jal. And then he starts building his relationship with his creator, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, building his iman, and we say now a person is mu'min, he is a believer, he has a faith, he is a true mu'min. Quran says that uses the term mu'minun haqqa. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned certain qualities of the people who are mu'min, who are called the mu'min. For example, Surah Al-Fal, Allah Azza wa Jalla mentioned about those people that when they listen to the ayat of Allah, their iman increases. Whenever they listen to the ayat, recitation of the Quran, it leads them, you know, to increase in their faith, increase in their iman. They have tawakkal ala Allah, they put their trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they establish the salah, they spend from the wealth that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless them with. And then Allah azza wa jal calls them mu'minuna haqqa, they are the real, they are the true believers, they will have the forgiveness of their Rabb, and they will have high ranks with their Rabb. There's another stage which is called a person, he is now muttaqi. He was a Muslim, mu'min, and then we see another term which is muttaqi. And if we ask the question, where I am standing, where am I, in terms of my relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, one thing that can determine that is how much taqwa I have. Because Allah Azza wa Jal clearly mentioned that in the Quran of Al-Hujarat, إِنَّ أَكْرَمَكُمْ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ أَتْقَاكُمْ. Indeed, the person who has more taqwa of Allah, he is most closest to Allah Azza wa Jal. And as we always say, we cannot judge the taqwa of someone. A person, maybe sometimes we see he doesn't, from outward perspective, he doesn't seem to be religious. He doesn't have long beard. He doesn't have kufi. But maybe in reality, he is closest to Allah Azza wa Jal. Maybe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala liked one of his actions that he is doing on a continuous basis, and that action is liked so much by Allah Azza wa Jal that he is dearer, he is closer to Allah Azza wa Jal. So the term muttaqi is something that Allah Azza wa Jal mentioned many times in the Quran. In fact, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about the fasting, Allah says, لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. So in today's khutbah, we are going to talk about a passage in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about the Jannah, that I prepared the Jannah, and Allah says, وَسَارِعُوا إِلَىٰ مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ وَجَنَّةٍ عَرْضُهَا السَّمَاوَاتُ وَالْأَرْضُ أُعِدَّتْ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. That hasten, run towards the forgiveness of your Lord, and the Jannah is as vast as the heaven and the earth, and Allah prepared for those who have the taqwa. And then Allah Azza wa Jalla mentioned few qualities of people of taqwa, and then again Allah Azza wa Jalla, this is a unique passage in the Quran where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala started off mentioning the Jannah, and then ending that passage after those qualities also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala again mentions about the Jannah. And before mentioning about those qualities, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned two things that a person always need to keep in his mind, and that is the maghfirah, the forgiveness from Allah Azza wa Jal, and the, of course, the Jannah, which is our ultimate goal. That's what we are heading to. That's what we are working for. And as we were mentioning in last football also about that equation that we have, the winner, the fawz, the faiz will be someone, the winner will be the someone who will save himself from the hellfire and will enter in Jannah. Quran says, uses the term faqad faz. Indeed, he is the winner. So what are those qualities? Allah Azza wa Jalla mentioned that in Surah Al-Imran, from verse number 133 to 136, those qualities of the people of taqwa. The first quality Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ فِي السَّرَّاءِ وَالضَّرَّاءِ. Those who spend from their wealth. And now when we talk about spending from the wealth, most of the time we think that whenever I have something extra, or when I have the money, you know, with this kind of extra, I will spend in the way of Allah. But what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what is the real sadaqah, what is the real charity is, as Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, one of the best form of the charity is that when you want to spend and you have a fear that your wealth is going to decrease, you don't have that much extra, right? You barely may be fulfilling your needs, but still you relate that whatever you have to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you spend from that. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said this is one of the best form of charity. When a person spends from his wealth and he had fear that his wealth will decrease, but still he does that. He doesn't have that much extra. That's why this ayah doesn't say only that those who spend from their wealth. But Allah says, الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ فِي السَّرَّاءِ وَالضَّرَّاءِ. At the time of ease and at the time of difficulty. Most of the time when we are in a difficult situation, we are willing to do what pleases Allah. We are willing to do, or based on that we can ask Allah, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can take us out from that difficulty. But you know what is the real time? The time that we are enjoying the blessings of Allah. That is the time when we have to truly return back to Allah. If Allah blesses us with the health and we are enjoying our life, Allah blesses us with wealth, with children, and we, alhamdulillah, everything is going well. That is the real test, where we are standing at that time. Because in most of the cases in Quran, doesn't mention once, but many, many times in the Quran, وَإِذَا مَسَّكُمُ الضُّرُّ فِي الْبَحْرِ ضَلَّ مَن تَدْعُونَ إِلَّا إِيَّاهُ. And about the mushrikeen also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned that when they are in a difficult situation, they call upon Allah Azza wa Jal. But when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fulfill their needs, then مَرَّ كَأَن لَّمْ يَدْعُونَا إِلَى ضُرٍّ مَسَّهُ. Allah says in Surah Al-Yunus, that they are walking on the earth in a manner that they were not in a tough situation. When we take them out, and after that, when they are at the time of ease, they are walking on the earth thinking that they were not even calling us back. Bad days when they were in a difficult situation, they were calling us. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took them out from that situation. And now when Allah azza wa jalla put them in ease, at the time of easiness, now they forgot Allah azza wa jalla. So when Allah azza wa jalla bless us with the wealth, and we are enjoying the luxuries of this dunya, and we have enough alhamdulillah to fulfill our needs, that is the time if we spend whatever we can. Allah knows our capacity. Allah knows what we can spend. And if we spend, truly spend it for this, for the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the way of Allah azza wa jal, that is one of the quality of the people of taqwa. As Quran mentions here, U'iddat lil-muttaqeen, alladheena yunfiquna fis-sarra'i wad-dharra'. Sadaqah, we talked about it many, many times, brothers and sisters, is something that is so important. And it should be a part of our daily life. There should not be a day goes by and we are not spending something in the way of Allah. Even if it is a dollar, even if it's a few cents. Because this is one of the things that can protect us. This is one of the things that can change your qadr, your predestination. La yaruddu al-qadra illa bis-sadaqati wa-dua. Rasulullah said, your qadr, your predestination can be changed with the sadaqah and with the dua. Sadaqah, dhillu al-mu'mini yawm al-qiyamah. It will be a shade for a believer on the day of judgment. Everyone will be looking for a shade and sun will be so closed. And you will see your sadaqah in form of that dhill on the day of judgment. If someone, yourself or someone from your family is sick, this is one of the best way that you spend in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with the intention that Allah azza wa jal give that person shifa. So this sadaqah, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, spending in the way of Allah azza wa jal is something so important. And that's what we see in the life of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Always he used to spend. Abdul Rahman ibn Awf radiyallahu anhu, Uthman ibn Affan radiyallahu anhu. And we have so many incidents that were recorded in the books, that they were always at the front foot when it came to the spending in the way of Allah. So make it as a habit that every day we are spending something in the way of Allah azza wa jal. Let your children also have that habit of spending in the way of Allah. Give them money. If you want to spend, maybe spend it through them. You know, our teacher used to say, you know, maybe we have a lot of sins, but subhanAllah, the kids, they don't have. So your sadaqah will be pure if you are giving them and they are spending it, alhamdulillah. So that is the first quality of the people of taqwa. أَلَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ فِي السَّرَّاءِ وَالضَّرَّاءِ. The second quality of the people of taqwa in Surah Al-Imran, Allah Azza wa Jalla mentions, وَالْكَاظِمِينَ الْغَيْرُ. وَالْكَاظِمِينَ الْغَيْرُ. Now, kadama in Arabic means that you do something and there are no traces of that thing even. For example, you were chewing the food, you had the food in your mouth, and you swallowed it. Now, you don't have anything in your mouth. There are no traces. Inside there can be, but outward there are no traces of that food. This is what the kalam is. That a person has the quality of wal-kalimin al-ghayr. What it means, that the person swallows the anger. That there are no traces of that anger even on his face. This is the quality of the people of taqwa. That not only that, sometimes we are not saying any words, right? We are not speaking, but on the facial, you know, expression tells that you are angry. But Allah Azza wa Jalla says, وَالْكَاظِمِينَ الْغَيْرُ. Those who swallow their anger. And how we can build that quality, how we can make it easy, that when we do it thinking that is for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I am doing it to please Allah azza wa jal. So in this beautiful passage where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about the people of taqwa, the qualities of the people of taqwa, the first quality Allah mentioned, those who spend from their wealth at the time of ease and the time of difficulty. وَالْكَاظِمِينَ الْغَيْظِ, those who swallow their anger. وَالْعَافِينَ عَنِ النَّاسِ. Now this is the third quality. Now what is عَفْ? As in the month of Ramadan, we are recommended to the dua that Aisha radiallahu anha, she asked Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what dua should I make if I find Laylatul Qadr? So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught her the dua, Allahumma innaka afuun tuhibbul afwa fa'afu anni. So what is the af? There's a difference between af and the maghfira. So af is a higher level. Af is that when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives, there are no traces of that sin, you know, even in not in our book of deeds. That is the higher level of the af. Here Allah Azza is mentioning about the quality of the people of taqwa, وَالْعَافِينَ عَنِ النَّاسِ. Those who forgive others out of love of Allah, and there are no traces as well of those. Something happened, they don't even recall it. Sometimes it happens that something happened, we say, yes, I forgive you. But after a year or so, again we remind. Remember, that is something that would happen. Although I forgive you, but Allah says, وَالْعَافِينَ عَنِ النَّاسِ. Those who forgive others out of love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but on top of that, they don't even recall that. They don't even remember that. They don't even, you know, ask that person, keep on reminding that person about that. وَالْعَافِينَ عَنِ النَّاسِ. وَاللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, interestingly, ended this ayah by saying, وَاللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. So what is the relationship of mentioning these three qualities of infaq fi sabilillah at the time of ease and at the time of, you know, difficulty, then mentioning about kaadhimeen al-ghayr, that you swallow your anger, وَالْعَافِينَ عَنِ النَّاسِ, you forgive others out of love, and Allah can lose that verse by ihsan. Ihsan. And as I was mentioning, there is an interesting, you know, connection with these, with the ihsan. As I was mentioning at the beginning of the khutbah about the Muslim, mu'min, right? And muttaqi. And there's another term that Quran uses, is the muhsin. And what is muhsin? What is ihsan? Ihsan is a higher level of doing something good. And you know, subhanAllah, where did Allah Azza wa Jalla use this word? Very commonplace, with parents. وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. So ihsan is a high level of doing something good, that you do good and you don't expect anything in return. That is ihsan. That is ihsan. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to spend in the way of Allah, to swallow our anger, to forgive others, not only for anything else, not only expecting, not, you know, expecting anything in return, but doing it only for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why Allah Azza wa Jalla, as Mufassirin, they mentioned, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala concluded this verse with the ihsan. Wallahu yuhibbul muhsineen. Allah Azza wa Jalla loves those who does the ihsan. Meaning they are doing, no, they are trying to do any action, any deed, spending in the way of Allah, or any other, you know, deed that they do, keeping in mind that ihsan. Another definition of ihsan in Hadith Jibra'il, as very famous hadith that Jibra'il salam came, and he said with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the Sahaba, they could not understand what kind of, you know, person he is, that he was asking the question and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was replying. He asked, Mal Islam, Mal Iman, Mal Ihsan, Mal As-Sa'ah, when is the day of judgment? And then when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was replying him, so he was saying, Sadaqt. Whatever you're saying is truth. The Sahaba, they were saying that we could not understand what kind of person he is, that he is asking the question, meaning that he doesn't know it. But when Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is replying him back, then he says, Sadaqta. Whatever you said is truth. And then when he left, it is a hadith by Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu. So Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam asked the Sahaba, do you know who he was? So they always, out of respect, they said, Allahu wa Rasuluhu a'lam. Allah and Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam knows best. And then Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, he was Jibra'il. Atani yu'allimukum deenakum. He came to teach you the deen. So one of the questions that Jibra'il alayhisalam asked in that conversation with Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, mal ihsan? What is ihsan? So Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam replied back saying, an ta'bud Allah ka'annaka tara, fa in lam takun tara fa innahu yarak. Subhanallah. Look at the level of ibadah, of worship. That Rasul said, "An ta'bud Allah, you worship Allah as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching you. An ta'bud Allah ka'annaka tara. Sorry. You are worshipping Allah as you are watching Allah. And if you cannot bring that feeling, then at least have that feeling that Allah is watching you. So when we stand in the prayer and we say, Allahu Akbar, how many times we have that feeling that I am watching Allah. Allah is right there. I gave this example many times before also. In Arabic language, we say, Iyaka na'budu. You know, in Arabic, when we say, Qalam, Qalamuka, your pen. So the person is right in front of me, right? Your pen, second person. So Allah Azza wa Jalla uses that term in Surah Al-Fatiha that we recite at least 17 times in a day. Iyaka na'budu. Wallah, we worship you alone. Meaning he is right there. Rasulullah ﷺ said, a person is most closest to Allah in the state of sajda, in the prayer. So in order to achieve that level of ihsan, for example, in our prayer, when we stand and we say, Allahu Akbar, bring that feeling that you are watching Allah. Thinking about the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that is what Rasulullah ﷺ said in the hadith, مَلْ إِحْسَانَ أَن تَعْبُدَ اللَّهَ كَأَنَّكَ تَرَاهُ فَإِنْ لَمْ تَكُنْ تَرَاهُ فَإِنَّهُ يَرَاكَ. So we are discussing that unique passage of the Quran in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned about Jannah and then mentioned about the qualities of the people of Taqwa. And then again Allah Azza wa Jal mentioned that the forgives other out of love for the sake of Allah. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala concluded verse by saying, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves those who have the quality of Ihsan, those who are Muhsin. The fourth quality that Allah mentioned in the next ayah, وَالَّذِينَ إِذَا فَعَلُوا فَاحِشَةً أَوْ ظَلَمُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ. That those, when they, not if, but when they, إِذَا فَعَلُوا, when they commit any fahisha. Now fahisha is anything, as one of the definitions that scholars say, anything that can lead a person to commit adultery, to commit zina. Anything that leads to that is called fahisha. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala uses the term idha, when they commit a fahisha. Anything that can lead to the zina, to commit the adultery. أَوْ ظَلَمُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ. Or they wrong themselves, committing any kind of sin, lying, backbiting. وَالَّذِينَ إِذَا فَعَلُوا فَاحِشَةً أَوْ ظَلَمُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ. What is their first reaction? Allah mentioned two things here. The first thing straight away, what they do? Dhakarullah. They remember Allah. They remember Allah. Fastaghfaru lidhunubihim. And the second thing, it's not only they remember Allah, means that they straight away, remember that we have mentioned the qualities of the people of taqwa. Straight away that khashiyah, the fear of Allah comes in their heart. They remember Allah, and the next thing they do, فَاسْتَغْفَرُوا لِذُنُوبِهِمْ. They ask for forgiveness for their sin. SubhanAllah. That is the reaction. That should be the asloob of a true believer, a true muttaqi. We all, disobey Allah Azza wa Jal, knowingly or unknowingly, intentionally or unintentionally. But the real, as Rasulullah said, كُلُّ بَنِي آدَمَ خَطَّاءٌ وَخَيْرُ الْخَطَّائِينَ التَّوَّابِينَ. that all the sinners, every son of Adam is a sinner. But the best of the sinners are those who are tawwabin. And one of the meaning of tawwab, whenever you hear this in Arabic language, this tawwab, repetition of that wow, means a person commits the sin, comes back, and asks for forgiveness. Again commits the sin and again comes back. That is tawwab, is from tawbah. That he commits the sin and again he comes back to Allah Azza wa Jal for forgiveness. وَالَّذِينَ إِذَا فَعَلُوا فَاحِشَةً أَوْ ظَلَمُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ ذَكَرُوا اللَّهِ فَاسْتَغْفَرُوا لِذُنُوبِهِمْ. And then look at the mercy of Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, O my slave, وَمَنْ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. Who can forgive your sin other than Allah? Doesn't matter. Your sins can never overcome the rahmah of Allah, the mercy of Allah. As long as we are taking this breath, we have a chance. Those few moments of true repentance, of tawbatan nasuha. Wallahi, it doesn't matter. We have the story of Musa alayhi salam, and we mentioned it many times as well, a person who was disobeying Allah for 40 years, and they were in the desert. Musa alayhi salam asked for the rain. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, let that person, that individual, who disobeyed me for 40 years, let him to be on the side, and I will, send the rain. What that individual did, those few moments of repentance, the tawbah and nasuha, he looked at left and right, thinking maybe someone else Allah Azza is talking about, but then when he realized that he is the one whom Allah is talking about, right standing there, he returned back to Allah in those few moments. 40 years of disobedience of Allah, those few moments of repentance, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the rain. Now Musa alayhi salam, he asked the question from Allah, Allah, you asked me that the person should separate himself from the gathering, but no one did it, but still you blessed us with rain. So Allah azza wa jalla says, because of the sincere repentance of that individual, I blessed all of you with this rain. And now Musa alayhi salam had another question, that, oh Allah, can I see that person? Who is he? Can I see him? And look at the mercy of Allah, the rahmah of Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to Musa alayhi salam, oh Musa, I hid his sin for 40 years. He was disobeying me for 40 years. And I hid his sin. And now when he returned back to me, you want me to disclose him? Allahu Akbar. Sattarul uyub. Sattarul uyub. So Allah Azza wa says, وَمَنْ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. Who can forgive our sins other than Allah? We have, as long as we are alive, few moments of repentance. Few moments when we are truly sincere in our repentance. Because when we talk about tawbah, there are certain conditions that when we are asking for repentance, first of all, we need to admit the sin. That yes, oh Allah, I'm admitting that I committed these sins. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned very important thing at the end of this verse by saying, وَلَمْ يُصِرُّوا عَلَى مَا فَعَلُوا وَهُمْ يَعْلَمُونَ. That he doesn't just, deep down he's saying that yes, oh Allah, I'm asking for your repentance, but deep down still he wants to go back to commit that sin. And Allah says, وَلَمْ يُصِرُّوا عَلَى مَا فَعَلُوا وَهُمْ يَعْلَمُونَ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala concluded that again by saying, by mentioning the Jannah, أُولَٰئِكَ جَزَاؤُهُمْ مَغْفِرَةٌ مِّن رَبِّهِمْ وَجَنَّاتٌ تَجْرِي مِن تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارُ خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا وَنِعْمَ أَجْرُ الْعَامِلِينَ. عَامِلِينَ. This word is very important. عَمَل is something that will save us, not the ilm. عَامِلِينَ. Those who put all these what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the amal. And that is what we should ask from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That Allah Azza wa give us the tawfiq to implement that what we know. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make all of us among those who spend from their wealth in sarrahi wa dharra. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the tawfiq to bring these qualities of the people taqwa in our lives. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum. Astaghfiruhu innahu huwal ghafurur rahim. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. قال سبحانه, إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي, يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين، اللهم انصر إخواننا المستضعفين في كل مكان، اللهم انصرهم في كشمير، اللهم انصرهم في كشمير، اللهم انصرهم في فلسطين وفي العراق وفي أفغانستان وفي كل مكان يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم انصر من نصر دين محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم واجعلنا منهم، واخذل من خذل دين محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم ولا تجعلنا منهم. اللهم إنا نسألك إيمانا كاملا ويقينا صادقا ورزقا واسعا ولسانا ذاكرا وقلبا خاشعا وتوبة نصوحا وتوبة نصوحا وتوبة قبل الموت وراحة عند الموت والعفو عند الحساب والفوز بالجنة والنجاة من النار. ربنا اغفر لنا ولوالدينا وارحمهم كما ربونا صغارا. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. الحمد لله رب العالمين.